the truth about Thanksgiving and Hanukkah by Michael Israel. That you never knew. Red TV.
Even though it was a massacre that, you know, that was all not, that was being set up, and therefore they were all thinking of, the Europeans were thinking to rob them the entire time.
That's right.
But these kind people were still willing to give their land, give their food, and share with them. And we almost, when we celebrate Thanksgiving, we almost, again, we see it from the European perspective.
That's right.
As I'm giving you something and you're giving me something, when ultimately the natives were saving the Europeans. I think, again, that truth needs to come to the forefront of why these holidays were created, and even the purpose. And like,
silence is betrayal. If you know the truth and don't say the truth, then the blood is on your hands. Proverbs chapter 1, verse 22. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity, and the scorners delight in their scorning? And fools hate knowledge. A lot of us have been wanting to know the real answers for some time. And today you will get just that. If you've been praying for this, if you've been asking the Lord to show me something new, give me some new information, I want to know the truth, well, here is that today. We can't enjoy the simplicity of this world and its traditions, its evil pagan traditions, and hate the knowledge that we get. There's been times in our life where we've been given the truth and we're like, no, I don't want to hear it. Oh no, I don't want to know. I'm good. Whichever way we say it, we hated that knowledge and we were fools. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 15. Therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold the traditions which ye have been taught, whether by word or our epistle. So you're going to learn a lot of things today that is dramatically life-changing for the better. And you have to hold tight to these new traditions. We have to put away the past. And we have to praise the Lord with these wonderful and beautiful celebrations. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 2. Now I praise you, brethren, that ye remember me in all things and keep the ordinances as I delivered them to you. So again, keep these traditions. This is an ordinance, and it's a blessing that you're about to receive. Enjoy it. Now, the real question is, where is Hanukkah in the Bible? The actual word Hanukkah means dedication. And we're going to talk about exactly what's going on. Exodus chapter 23, verses 14 through 16. Now, we're going to read from this, and we're going to see exactly what feast we need to celebrate. Three times thou shalt keep a feast unto me in the year. Ooh. It says only three times? Well, let's see what feasts they are. Thou shalt keep the feast of unleavened bread. Thou shalt eat unleavened bread 7 days, as I commanded thee, in the time appointed in the month Abib. For in it thou camest out from Egypt. And none shall appear before me empty. And the feast of harvest, the first fruits of thy labor, which thou hast sown in the field, and the feast of ingathering, which is in the end of the year, when thou hast gathered in thy labors out of the field. So we have three feasts that are mentioned. We have the Feast of Unleavened Bread, which is also known as Passover. You have the Feast of Harvest, and we have the Feast of Ingathering. So how come it doesn't mention Hanukkah? Where's the word Hanukkah? Or how come it doesn't mention the Feast of Dedication? Well, as we know from previous shows, for those who have been in tune, we have to read line upon line and precept upon precept. We read here a little and there a little. So we don't just stop at this chapter. We search the scriptures. The scripture says search the scriptures. The scripture says study to show thyself approved. So you have to read more than one source from the Bible. Okay? So we're going to do just that. Now, another thing is for the Feast of Harvest and the Feast of Ingathering. How many of us wish that we had land and we had a farm that want to do this? Because when you get closer to Christ, when you become closer with our Heavenly Father Yahweh, you want to do more for Him. You want to please Him in so many ways. If He tells you to do this, you want to do that. If He tells you to jump, you jump. If He tells you to run, you run. He tells us that there's a Feast of Harvest, but how can we harvest if we don't have land? How can we ingather and we don't have any land? We don't have any produce. So we need to make some changes for the future. We need to get land. We need to get produce. And we need to do just that so we can celebrate. Now, since we don't have those things, that doesn't mean that we can't celebrate. We can still go to the grocery and we can get what we need to, you know, have a great time. And when the Lord gives us a holiday, a holy day, it is holy days. It is a blessing. Whereas you have Christmas, you have Thanksgiving, you have a new year, right? It's only a one-day celebration. But when the Lord celebrates, He wants us to do it big. He wants us to go live. He wants us to do it up. Let's go on. As we move forward, I just want to remind you that this information is not for everyone. Some will oppose and some will embrace. But whoever you are, I just want to show you this scripture, John chapter 6, verse 70. And Yeshua answered them, "Have not I chosen you 12, and one of you is a devil?" The Lord will choose people to receive information, to bring them closer to Him, for Yahweh. And some will oppose. But regardless, the information is to go out to everyone. And then it is up to that individual, if he has an ear to hear and to take heed to the Lord's word. Now, don't get confused though, because if the one who opposes the scripture, the scripture is not saying that person is the devil. It is saying that person is a devil. It's a complete difference. The devil walks to and fro, but a devil can be in partnership with the devil. Reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 33. "For our Heavenly Father, the great and loving I Am, is not the author of confusion, but of peace. As in all the churches of the saints, the Lord is not the author of confusion." Everything is plain. Everything is simple. Everything is clear. But how clear is it for those who don't know the day of Thanksgiving? Like, do you know which day is Thanksgiving? I always had a problem with that. One day it was this. Another one it was this. Thanksgiving is the last Thursday in November. But the date changes all the time. How confusing is that? So devilish. How many of us like a good spread? Beans, greens, tomatoes, jam, yam, turkey, and all the fixings, right? Well, since we love food, And since you love food, the Lord has something a little bit better. So much better, in fact, that words can barely explain how majestic and holy and powerful and loving our Lord and Yahweh really is. When it comes to food, we all know about the Last Supper. Another holy moment for us. In addition to the dinner with our bridegroom in heaven, once all of this is over. Now, in scripture, reading from John chapter 7, verses 1 through 2, we're going to learn a little bit more, and we're going to find out about all these other meals that are very, very important in scripture. Let's read. After these things, Yeshua walked in Galilee, for he would not walk in Jewry, because the Jews sought to kill him. Now the Jews' feast of Tabernacles was at hand. A couple of things to pull from the scripture, well, three actually, that we'll speak of is the place that he didn't want to walk. Jewry is just another name for Judea. That's just another name for a city of Jews, right? City of Judea. He didn't want to go there. The other thing is that there was this huge feast going on, the Feast of Tabernacles, and he was around. The third thing to pull from this is that we're going to notice that Christ's attendance around these three different feasts that we're going to read of is paramount. He was always around when the feast was going on. It didn't say that he took part necessarily, but he was there. And for those who are in truth, knows what's going on. John chapter 10, verse 22 through 23. And it was at Jerusalem, the Feast of Dedication, also known as Hanukkah, and it was winter. And Yeheshua, the Mashiach, walked into the temple in Solomon's porch. Let's analyze this, okay? Now, Yeshua, he went to this temple in the wintertime for the Feast of Dedication. It didn't say that he ate, but he went there during this time. It's similar to how he made wine from water. He made it, but it never said that he drank any of it, right? We can only assume. Now, another thing is that winter solstice is every year on the 21st. Pretty much. Keep this date in mind. John chapter 12, verse 1. Then Yehoshua, 6 days before the Passover, came to Bethany where Lazarus was, which had been dead, whom he raised from the dead. This is another important moment where scripture speaks about a feast, Passover, not Easter, but 6 days before the Feast of Passover. In regards to Passover, it's in the month of March. Deuteronomy 16, verse 1. Observe the month of Abib and keep the Passover unto the Lord thy Elohim. For in the month of Abib, the Lord thy Most High brought thee forth out of Egypt by night. And the Lord spoke unto Moses and Aaron and the land of Egypt, saying, this month shall be unto you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year to you. Not New Year's Eve, not January 1st, but the month of March. Abib is March. As we read from the Easton's Bible Dictionary version, an ear of corn, the month of newly ripe grain, the first of the Jew ecclesiastical year, and the seventh of the civil year. It began about the time of the vernal equinox on March 21st. Okay, also known as Nisan or the month of Abib. When the ball drops in New York, it's not the new year. December 31st does not bring in the new year. Now, let's get back to Hanukkah. And one of the first things that we should know is that the word Kaslu, okay, is the third month of the civil year and the ninth month of the Jew sacred calendar on the Hebrew calendar falling in November through December of the Gregorian calendar. Now let's get to the scripture. 1 Maccabees chapter 4 verses 52 through 59. Now on the 5th and 20th day of the 9th month, we're talking about November 25th, which is called the month Casalu, in the 140th and 80th year, they rose up bedtimes in the morning and offered sacrifice according to the law upon the new altar of burnt offerings which they had made. Look at what time and what day the heathen had profaned it. Even in that was it dedicated with songs, cisterns, and harps and cymbals. Then all the people fell upon their faces, worshiping and praising the Most High of heaven, who had given them good. And so they kept the dedication of the altar 8 days and offered burnt offerings with gladness and sacrificed the sacrifice of deliverance and praise. They decked also the forefront of the temple with crowns of gold, with shields, and the gates and chambers they renewed, and hanged doors upon them. Thus, their very great gladness among the people, for that the reproach of the heathen was put away. Moreover, Judas and his brethren with the whole congregation of Israel ordained that in the days of the dedication of the altar should be kept in their season from year to year by the space of 8 days, from the 5th and 20th day of the month Casalu, with mirth and gladness. Okay, so Judas that we're speaking of is not the Judas that betrayed Christ. There's two Judases in scripture, okay? And this is the good one. The other thing is that, again, we have another reference, line upon line, precept upon precept, that this goes on from November 25th for 8 days. 2 Maccabees 1, letter to the Jews of Egypt about the feast of dedication. The brethren, the Jews that be at Jerusalem and the land of Judea, wish unto brethren, the Jews that are throughout Egypt, health and peace. The Most High be gracious unto you, and remember his covenant that he made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, his faithful servants, and give you all in heart to serve him and to do his will with a good courage and willing mind, and open your hearts in his law and commandments, and send you peace, and hear your prayers, and be at one with you, and never forsake you in the time of trouble. And now, we be here praying for you, what time as Demetrius ring, in the 69th year, we the Jews wrote unto you the extremity of trouble that came upon us in those years. From that time, Jason and his company revolted from the holy land and the kingdom, and burned the holy land and kingdom, and burned the porch, and shed innocent blood. Then we prayed unto the Lord, and we were heard. We offered also sacrifices and fine flour, and lighted the lamps, and set forth the loaves. And now see that you keep the feast of tabernacles in the month of Chislev. Chislev is another word for Casalu, but it's the Jew calendar of November through December. Verse 10. In the 84th year, the people that were at Jerusalem and in Judea in the council, and Judas, this is the good Judas, sent greeting and health unto Aristobulus, king of Ptolemy's master, who was of the stock of the anointed priest, and to the Jews that were in Egypt, insomuch as the Most High had delivered us from great perils. We thank him highly as having been in battle against the king, for he cast them out that fought within the holy city. For when the leader was come into Persia and the army with him that seemed invincible, they were slain in the temple of Nania by deceit of Nania's priest. For Antiochus, as though he would marry her, came into the place, and his friends that were with him received money in name of a dowry, which when the priest of Nania had set forth, and he was entered with a small company into the compass of the temple, they shut the temple as soon as Antiochus was come in, and opening a privy door of the roof, they threw stones like thunderbolts and struck down the captain, hewed them in pieces, smote off their heads, cast them to those that were without. Blessed be our Elohim in all things, who had delivered up the ungodly. Therefore, whereas we are now proposed to keep the purification of the temple upon the 5th and 20th day of the month Chislev, we thought it necessary to certify you thereof, that ye may also keep it as the Feast of Tabernacles and of the fire, which was given us when Nehemiah offered sacrifice. After that, he builded the temple and the altar. In this excerpt, we're proposed to keep the month of November, which is known as Chislev in Hebrew, November 25th, as the starting day of Hanukkah. Just as we celebrate the Feast of Tabernacles, we celebrate this Feast of Hanukkah in dedication to getting our temple back because of all the evil that was taking place there. Such a blessing. Refresher, Chislev is another word for November, okay? Leviticus 23:37, we're going to wrap it up, because these are the feast of the Lord, which ye shall proclaim to be holy, convocations to offer an offering made by fire unto the Lord, a burnt offering, a meat offering, a sacrifice, and drink offerings, everything upon this day. And you've got some choices to make, because Thanksgiving this year is November 25th, the exact same day as the start of Hanukkah. So what are you going to do? What are you going to do? According to the world, the Feast of Dedication, also known as Hanukkah, is on the 28th. So somebody's lying to you, because the scripture says November 25th. In fact, according to the world, Hanukkah changes every single year. Every single year, the devil has changed the date of Hanukkah for those who truly want to celebrate. The word of the Lord tells us to search the scripture. Study to show thyself approved. This menorah is not the right one. It's cute, but it has 9 sticks. This menorah candle is definitely not the one. It has a star that's nowhere found in scripture that looks like this. And it has 9 candle holders. This is definitely not the one. Some people want to do it up for Hanukkah, but this is not it, right? And then look at the price, right? However, if you have one candle, whether it's a birthday candle or it looks like this, or it's a flameless candle, or your check didn't come and you only have your phone as a light, the Lord will still bless you because he know your heart. My menorah looks something like this. But regardless of what you have, this is a special and beautiful time for us to celebrate. It's not about turkeys. It's not about pilgrims and Indians. It's a special time. And a feast that we shall all enjoy and celebrate and be happy, because it's a beautiful and blessed time. You have the truth now. It's up to you to decipher and to choose which path you're going to take.
How do you say Hanukkah? How do you say the light? How do you light the lights? The lights, the lights, the lights, the lights.
Turkeys are most of the turkeys that are sold for Thanksgiving, but experts also say another option are fresh turkeys. They don't like that idea.